Okay, we're gonna do a little, I guess, unboxing here. The new shotgun I just got in. This is a Norinco JW83. It's like a single shot, break open shotgun, 16 gauge, 30-inch barrel. It appears to be a full choke. This came from Canada Ammo. They're on sale right now for like $79. And all about cheap guns, and all about cheap guns that are decent quality and practical. And the single shot shotgun is probably one of the more practical guns you can have or own, or, you know. So these sort of appear to be like new old stock. They're all probably 20 years or older. Just look at like the way the label is. The wording in the manual is quite poor. Like the translation and stuff sort of gives you an idea that it's fairly old. Like the staples in the box even are like quite corroded and things. So, but they're basically brand new. They've just been sitting for quite a few years. But they're not. I don't really see any evidence of any deterioration or stuff like that. So they're pretty much, they're good as being like brand new, like made yesterday. So there's not a, that doesn't bother me at all. And so I'll just do a little overview: what's in the box, what to get when you buy one of these. It comes in this really nice fancy box, and this model. It even says shotgun. It says where it's made, and it's a Zhongzhou machinery plant, China North Industry Corporation, or Norinco. Get your owner's manual or operation manual, and the gun is broken down into its three parts here, and now I'll go into little spots. They come like in plastic bags with oil on them. This one's been cleaned. They appear like they might have came with like a, I don't know, screwdriver or something, what that might have been, but they're not there. They never were. So, but we'll just go over some of the features of the different parts. I won't put it together when I'm doing that, because it's just easier to show you. But they, you know, it goes together like any break open shotgun. Pretty much everybody's seen one of those, I think. We might go over the manual. It has the specifications in here, and there's some funky wording of different stuff in it. But it's in Chinese as well as in English, so I don't know if they actually sold these guns in China or not, or I'm not sure if people can own guns in China, but I imagine the communist government probably wouldn't be afraid of, like, a farmer that had, like, a single-shot shotgun. It wouldn't be too dangerous to the government. And for a practical standpoint, that would be a decent gun, like a 16 or something like that. Be a decent gun or shotgun for, you know, a farmer to have. Like, if you have a, you know, bloodthirsty panda or something's trashing your rice paddy or something, you can probably do for them. So there's all kinds of small birds and stuff that, like, they eat anything that's going over there. So it's a practical gun. So anyway, so let's go over. Let's start with this, I guess. All right, so you got nice hardwood stock. It's sort of like a chew wood kind of deal. It's got a pretty good squishy recoil pad, and there's two Phillips screws that hold that in. You take that off to get access to the, there's a bolt in here that holds the on the receiver. It's sort of an H&R clone or ripoff. It's got the flat socket that the wood goes into here. And I like this because, like, a lot of shotguns, they have like a tang that goes here, and that ends up splitting the stock. This doesn't, won't suffer from that. It's got a cross bolt safety, which is, I don't know why they even bother with that, but it's there. But because it also has a a shoe, safety shoe in there, so it's safe to carry it like this. So you technically don't need the safety, but it's there, I guess. You just kind of ignore it, I guess. And to open it, this little lever, or whatever you want to call it. And she looks like a cast receiver. She's pretty damn simple, actually. Like, there's not a whole lot, but it's all, like, there's no plastic here. There's all metal. Nothing that's, you know, like a rubber recoil pad. Everything else is metal or wood. I kind of like that because seems like a lot of newer guns now, they've gone to the so-called more modern materials, which I don't go with. The Chinese, they kind of, I guess their gun industry was a little bit more archaic or something, so they stuck with metal and wood, and pretty much all their guns are still like that, but they've changed a bit now, but when this was built, so here's your four wood, it's pretty well checkered, actually, it's quite nice. And there's your lever there to put it on off. I like that way that's set up a lot better than the other shotguns just have like a spring-loaded thing in here and you snap it on. And a lot of times they get loose or you snapping them on, they end up cracking. If they're thin up here, it ends up cracking the wood and stuff. But you can also see the real color of the wood here. It's quite blonde compared to this finish they put on it. And it's well secured. There's three screws down through here. And your pivot, or your hinge here is metal, which I like. A lot of other cheaper, lower end, or whatever, value price break open shotguns, they have plastic here, like the ones from Brazil, the CBC, like Remington sold them, and they also were sold here under by CIL. They put plastic here, and in Canada, when it gets cold, that just breaks. And same with like the Cooey shotguns, when Winchester took them over, they changed that pivot part there to plastic, and they're broken. Like a lot of gun shops, you'll find boxes full of this part of the shotgun because it just broke. Or like if you build out of a decent quality as plastic, you'd probably be all right. But a lot of times they use it, they make it into like plastic that's like made it's really low end plastic. It's like melted down milk jugs or something. Like it's just crap. But so there's that. And you got your barrel. Let's read the things on here. It's 16 gauge, 2¾ inch, and it says F, which I would figure is full choke. BBL, barrel length 30 inches. And then you got your ejector. Or not really ejector, it's just an extractor. It just pushes the shell out, it doesn't throw it out. And, I like that. Like some of them are spring loaded and they end up getting stuck sometimes or whatever. And this one, if you get shell's a little bit sticky, you just have to refund a bit more because it's actuated by these, I guess those grooves that are in the receiver there. This is bronzed on, which is quite normal. The lug here. It's not very common that the barrel and the lug are one piece, but looks to be a decent bronzing job. This is bronzed on as well, a little for the latch, for the handguard. The choke appears to be bored into the barrel. You can look in, it's about this long. You can look in and it's, you can kind of see the taper, kind of tapers up into the, and then there's a straight area, or appears to be that way. The barrel is actually really nice and shiny in this. There's not any. You can see a tiny bit of machining marks, but it's actually very, very decent. I've seen way worse for guns that actually sold for more. But that's pretty good. So this is a little overview. We're going to do some shooting tests with it and patterns and stuff like this. Okay, maybe I'll get the... Let's turn the camera off for a second. We'll come back and we'll look at the manual here, give you the specifications on it. Maybe I'll put it together just at the end just to show you how it looks and so forth. But, okay, we'll go over the manual here, read some of the specifications and stuff. And then maybe at the end I'll put the gun together and show you some stuff about that. But it's certified made in China. That's an important thing to know. Not there. Let's see. So let's read some of the little opening stuff here, and then I'll talk about read the specifications and stuff. It's all in metric, but it's useful, I guess. Usage: the short gun, I guess that's spelled wrong, is mainly for hunting birds and middle or small animals. And it says features: all steel parts of the short gun are made of. It's kind of a long gun, actually. Yeah. Are made of high quality steel and properly heat treated. All the exposed Metal surfaces are all well polished. You know, they're not bad. The stock and handguard wood are made of high quality wood and turned out with advanced surface painting techniques, not be out of shape for long term use. So I guess the finish can stand up to being beat around, I guess. Alright, so we'll go over the different stuff here. See, caliber is 12 and 16. 16 is in brackets. Barrel length, 760 millimeters, which I guess that translates to 30 inches. Aim line length, 764 millimeters. So I don't know if that goes from the bead to the... That's that little groove in the top of the receiver, I think. Way of cartridge loading, single cartridge loading. That's kind of funny. Trigger pull is 15 to 30 N, which, I don't know if that's newtons or what that is. I don't know, how many pounds is that? I don't know. Overall weight, 3.2 kilograms, which is like 6.5 pounds, I believe. Overall length, width, height, and just, you know, like overall how long it is, and all some millimeters. Highest average bore pressure, 58.5 MPa, which is, that's something pascals. I don't deal with this crap in metric normally. Initial velocity, 350 meters per second. And then it has choke. It has 1 for 1, 1 for 2, 1 for 4, 3, like, you know, 1 quarter, 3 quarter. Not sure what they mean, but I kind of figure maybe 1/1 or would be cylinder bore, 1/2 would be, I don't know, modified. 1/4 would be like, I don't know, proof cylinder or something like that. 3/4 would be full, I guess. This one appears to be full choke. Firing, this must be constriction, I guess, or concentration, I don't know. How much the choke is, I guess. And the target is 35 meters away, no less than 65% of the pellets are within a circle of 750 millimeters, so that's, yeah, like 2-foot group, I guess, or whatever it is, or so. That's not bad, or 2.5 feet, I guess. Cartridge 16 gauge standard shotgun canister, it says. Effective range 50 meters. Duration 5,000 bullets. So I guess it has a service life of like 5,000 rounds before it breaks. Trouble rate 0.5%, except for breakdown of cartridge. So I guess you can't blame crappy ammo on the gun. That seems pretty decent though. 5,000 rounds. That's, you know, seems like a pretty good long life. And it has how to load it and how the safety works. Shows you the different. They call them guard wood unit, barrel unit, receiver unit. cautions. A couple of them are kind of weird, but don't load over tightened canister into chamber. So don't put bigger shells in it, or tight shells, like. Guess. I don't know how you could. And then it also says only the cartridges up to the size of the shotgun shotgun be used. So it almost sounds like you could shoot smaller cartridges in it, I guess, or does that mean you can shoot shorter shells? Or don't know. And it has a parts list. And you got your address and everything for, I guess that Zong Zhao machine plant or whatever. You get your fax number, your telephone number, so you can call them up and tell them how happy you are with your fine purchase. They'll probably be like, what? We don't make those here anymore. We're making stuff for Dollarama now. But anyway, so I'm pretty happy with it. Seems to be pretty decent. Just the last part of the video here, I just pull her together and show you how she was getting pretty good. Knock stuff over with the barrel here. This goes on pretty well. You just put that on, put a little lever out, and there you go. This one has a little bit wobble in it, but it's not a big deal. Just press the button to open her. It opens quite easily though. And she says, I didn't mention this receiver, it says JW83, made in China, that's all it really says on there. She's all metal and wood, which is what I like. So yeah, so they're still on sale right now at Canned Ammo, I guess, if you're interested in it, or it looks like a decent shotgun. It's pretty cheap, and let's do some shooting tests with it, see how it patterns and stuff, to see if it's worth my while to try to actually shoot at pigeons with it. I'm not very good at it anyway, but... So, anyway, that's my sort of the first impressions, little review on it. So we'll probably have something more about it here soon. So you guys talk to you guys later.